Welcome back to my YouTube channel, Travel with Flex. So today, guys, I'll be showing you guys tutorials or how to apply to Sweden application process, how to just to navigate the website, to search the courses, how to filter and stuff like that. So I'm going to show you guys how to do that and how to apply. I'm going to start from the scratch, create new account, how to create the account, do this, do that, put your courses and area that thing. And right now, the application is on. My previous video, I made mistake of saying July, whereas June is June. The application is on and it's going to close on 15th of August. That's the deadline. 15th of August is the deadline. So guys, stay tuned as I take you guys through this. And please guys, have a goal, something that I need to meet up with by this time next month. I want to hit 1,000 subscribers. So right now, please, I beg, just help me tap on the subscribe button down there, tap on it, then give it a like, give video a like, and also turn on the notification bell. Any video I upload, you'll be the first person to watch. So please up subscribe and let's go straight to the video.
These are the steps, and let's start this way. So basically, this is the website, universityadmission.se. So I'm actually using my phone right now to do the recording, so but I'm sure it's very wide for you to see and understand. So for you to start, you can see the interface here. It's very straightforward. Right here, you can see Spring 2024. Spring 2025 already started. Yeah, you can see it's right here, Spring 2024. When you tap on this key of these keywords here, e.g. subject slash course name location, there you can find courses. So we are coming back to that place. As you can see on the notification, but you can see 1st of June. So the application already started and it's going to end on 15th of August. So you can apply for masters, apply for bachelor's, then dates and deadlines. So that's these are things you can just check by yourself, you know, get familiar with the website. So basically, the tutorial is all about how to start the registration process. So here we go. So the first thing you have to do is just tap on this login. Tap on the login. So the login will take you to, yeah, it brings you to another portal. Here you can see. So you can tap on create an account. As you can see here, create an account, because you're just starting. So once you tap on create an account, you tell you, do you have a Swedish personal ID number? You don't have a Swedish personal ID number because you're not a citizen yet, or neither you staying there. So you just tap on no. So it's going to take you to another page. It's going to take you to another page. So right here, you're going to put your email and the password you want to make use of, as you can see here. So let me just use, I have my an email here. So since it's a fresh account, so in terms of the password, when you look at the password, you see lowercase letter, uppercase letter, a number, a special character, and the character have to be 8 to 15. So what I used to do is just make sure you can use your phone number, then your name. Depends on anything you want to use, just use anything. So I'll just put any just make sure it contains an uppercase, number, and at least a character, or you know, anything, if it's full stop or ASHO style, whatever you want to put, just put something, and it should be at least eight digits or whatever. So if you can see, I've already put the password here. So once you meet up the work criteria here, you can see everything is on green right now. So you repeat it here. So once you're done with that and you repeat it and it's correct, just tap on I'm not a robot. So when you've been verified, then you just tap on next. Okay, so what is there? Bicycle. Yeah, okay. Yeah, verify. You try again, traffic lights. Okay. Just have to do this so that will move. Okay, so next. So just tap on your next, and a code will be sent to your email. The code will be sent to your email. Yeah. So that code is what you copy to this place. So I've copied the code. So just for digit. So now, right here, I've already put the code and I tap on next. So now this is where you start the main registration, like just a mini registration like that. So you come here, you put your name. Let me just use a random name. I'm just using a random name, so because it's not going to be needed later. So on the Monday. So I'm just using something random. Not it's not serious. Why it's not needed. Okay. So on the Monday, date of birth. Just use any. I'm just gonna use anything. Put your date of birth here. No. Then you go ahead. Are you a male or a female? You put anyone. Then you next. So as you can see now, it's requesting for my phone number. As you can see here, it's requesting for your my phone number, address. You put your address, your postal code is optional. Also here, code address is also optional. The country, you put it there. City is necessary. Then you click on next. So once you click next, it's going to tell you congratulations, you've created your portal. So now, once you create this portal and click on the next, because right now I don't want to start filling information that I'm not going to make use of. So I'll just go straight to my own, because I have my own account here already existing, because I applied for an admission before. Yeah. So I'm going to use that. So I'm going to log into my account this time. So let me go back to login. So this login now is when you've already created it already. Once you click on this next, you've created your account, then use that login details to log in right here. So let me log in with my own details. I have my own details already, so automatically it logs in. Now I have an existing application, so you can see I was given I've been given admission before now. So I applied again and I was given, but I don't need it again. Sorry. So I don't really need it, so I just left it there, and I've been giving a lot of notification, do this, do that. So but that's not the main thing here. So the next thing you have to do right here now is the document you need to upload. So when you come here, you see the three lines here under this menu. When you tap it, you see entry requirement, you see apply masters, apply bachelor's, select selection and admission result. All these ones, yeah, you know, fine courses and whatever. So the main thing here we just need to do right now, let me come to this, my selection. Or before we go to my selection, let's talk about the documents. Tap on this my page, then you come to documents. That's number one. So when you come to documents, you upload the document that I requested for. Are you getting it? So yeah, you see understand document requirement. Before submitting your document, it's important to find out that you need to submit and how read through. Okay, blah blah, stuff like that. So you can read through that one by yourself. So identification document, maybe your international passport. You can see here, submit copy one of the following: valid passport, valid identity card with your citizenship listed. So you just have to upload it. So it's when you tap on this upload, you upload it there. So I've already uploaded mine, as you can see, submitted and with green. And it has been verified. So yeah, you see, provide education documents. Yeah, education documents. So you come here and upload your documents, you know. So yeah, I came here and I uploaded my birth certificate, I uploaded my primary school certificate, NECO certificate. Here you can see original certificate. You have to upload the original. If it's your master, if you're going for masters, you know, it has to be your bachelor's certificate. And note that your this thing, your transcripts have to be sent from the school directly, your school, university to the university here that you want to apply for. So you can see your NECO results. The scratch card was needed because they have to verify the results. Then testimonial. So as you can see, all of them have been verified. So now Do you receive a decision that you don't meet? Maybe I didn't meet any requirements or whatever, or maybe I didn't meet any of their requirements. So right here, I can appeal. My parents have been given admission already, as you can see. So if you see on this message here, it's just like they gave me a notification that I've been admitted, Lilio University of Technology, as you can see here. They sent me a message which I've not responded to, but I didn't actually check because I don't need it. Uppsala University also gave me admission, but I didn't actually check it. So these are, you know, the admission I got, but I don't need it. So yeah. So now let's go to selection of admission. So after you've done that and you've uploaded your documents and all those other stuffs, so now you come to my selection. Now this is where you choose or you search for courses, you know, that you need. So let's go to that place now so that we understand it. All these procedures are easy. Just be patient with it and you are good to go. Sorry, my network is quite slow. I don't know. Okay. So here we go. So as you can see here, find course and program. So let's just tap on find course and program. That's where you're going to search courses. So now, as you can see, Spring 2024. So you can just search for any course. Let's say you want to search for a course related to computer engineering. Let me put computer engineering. Computer engineering. So as you can see, if I tap on computer engineering, I tap on it, and this, see what it brought up for me? It brought many courses that are related to computer. So now whenever you see green, it means that that application is opened. Whenever you see this green, when I tap on the search, it brought it out. And right here, you can make use of filter. You see here, you see filter. Now you can choose on course program. Now you can choose on which university you want. So it's supposed to bring out a drop down, but okay, as you can see it here, these are list of university. So but I put on all universities, so any option, anything that is showing here is going to show all the universities. Now if you just only masters and you tap on masters level, now you see that here is going to change. As you see, it's loading, so it's going to show only courses. In respect to that, for masters, it's not going to show bachelor. So when I remove the masters and I only put it on bachelor, it's going to show only schools and courses for bachelor in respect to that computer engineering. So it's as simple as that, you know. Then if you just preparatory level, the same thing goes to that. So if you just your master's program, you know, you do the same thing, then you search for your course. Are you getting it? So once you search, let's say I select this computer aid engineering, select. Let's see. I've selected computer engineering CA. Is on if you tap on the show more. Now, when okay, you see now remove, and you can see course selected. So on my selection, you can see selection I've turned to 3. Then if I tap remove, it's gonna reduce. So now when you tap on show more, it's going to show you the tuition fee. You can see the tuition fee here. This is the total tuition fee for that course. Then you can see the requirement, the period, spring 2024, period 1, course date is going to start 15th of January. 2, 24 of March, level bachelor's, language of instruction, English, application code, you can see there. Then you can see the name of the school, Linus University, as you can see there. Then teaching from course on campus. If you see distance learning, just know that you can apply for visa. Then piece of study, half time. So it means that it's not a full-time program. You can also, you know, mix up with your work and other stuff. Instruction time, daytime, location, vast job. So as you can see, so these are the things. Look at this one too. You can see. So these are just the basic things. It's very easy. So once you select the course you want, if it's for masters, you can only select 4 courses. Then if it's for bachelor, you can select up to 8 different courses. So when you tap on this select here, it automatically see course selected. Then you come to my selection here. So once you tap on my selection, you can see we've choose the course we want. Then you see, when I start tap on, now these are the courses I want. So when I tap on start application, you can see start application. You can see now. You can see. So now here, this is where I prioritize the courses. Right here, I'm gonna prioritize the courses. So if you tap on this up, now this one, this number 2 is gonna become number 1. You see now it has changed to number 1. So anything I tap on this arrow, it changes the arrangement. So it shows that okay, this one I want first and other stuff. So once you've arranged it, you tap on continue. You can see here now, please answer the question that, you know, blah, blah. They're going to ask her some question, fee, and other stuff like that. So when you type and you click submit, it takes you to a portal where you have to pay. But me, I don't have to do that because I already did payments and other stuff like that. So it's as simple as that. So once you do, as you can see here, you can see confirmation. So when you come to this confirmation, it make you preview all the courses. Then you go ahead and pay and boom, you have to wait for the application results. You just check time to time, you know, stuff like that. That's what you do. So you just check time to time. So as you can see here, if you come to application fee, you can see you are not required to pay an application fee. You are verified that you don't need to. So because I've already paid before now. So I don't need to pay anymore. Okay, all these ones are closed. We don't need all these ones. I've already paid before, so that's this, guys. That is how to apply. It's as simple as that. So if you have any question, just hit me up on the comment section and I will respond to your question. So just try to get familiar with the website. You know, when you check date and deadline, you'll be able to see check date or deadline, you'll be able to see their deadlines here. You see here, autumn semester date, you can read everything here, you understand? So just try to get familiar with the website. You can see bachelor requirements. When you come to bachelor requirements, it's going to show you things that bachelor need, you know, all the course, all the this thing you need in requirements. It's going to show everything, you know, you can see it here. So this website carries all the old universities. Are you getting it? It carries all the university, like it's embedded into this particular website. So any school you choose, all of them are going to come here and check. And, you know, if they like you, you're good to go. So basically, that's just how to apply. And I think this will help you. So please, guys, don't forget to like and subscribe and turn on the notification bell. Thank you.
Guys, that is all about it. It's very easy. Once you're done with the application, wait for the admission result to come out. And even October admission too is to start the registration process, all the same. So once you wait and you are being admitted, then go on with paying of your tuition fee, then straight to visa process. And I did a video on visa process already. So I think that justifies everything. So it's as easy as that. If you have any question, drop it down below.